Hare Krishna everyone, welcome back to third session of this women's wellness retreat and third session of Ayurveda. And today we are going to discuss about the old age care. So old age care is also known as a geriatric care, and in this geriatric care we will see what Ayurveda says about it and what is the special care which we can take. So with the traditional Ayurveda, we are going to make old age a joyful and happy experience. So basically, geriatric is a medical science. It deals with the problems of the people who are 50 plus. So of any either 86, so 50, above 50 years, we consider them into the science called as a geriatrics. So in that, nowadays people are becoming more aware of this geriatric science because they are getting lots of problems, lots of health issues. So in Ayurveda, this geriatric science is also known as a rasayana chikitsa. So and that is specifically explained for the people who are going into this degenerative phase of the vata. So you can see when old age starts, mostly it is a retired life. Almost all the family responsibilities are completed. Children are well settled. Grandchildren will be there, and it's time to relax and enjoy. But when it is a time to relax and enjoy, then they notice that their body is not able to cooperate. So when it is a time to play with the grandchildren, the knees start aching. Or if it is a time to, like, if they feel that they want to lift the grandchildren, they can't because their shoulder starts paining. So a lot of joint issues starts. Then eyesight comes down. They feel that I should help with the kids in their studies, but memory also doesn't help. Appetite comes down. Because of the excess vata, gas trouble also starts. So most of the old age people, they come to us and they say, I'm getting lots of gas in my intestine, flatulence, indigestion, all those changes starts. And then they feel, actually it was a time to relax and enjoy, but because of all those things, I'm not able to feel comfortable. Sometimes so it becomes so difficult that they can't do their daily activities also. The joints become so stiff, or sometimes digestive problems also increases too much that even daily activities also becomes difficult for them. And then they start worrying about it. So this, our ancient Ayurveda, it understood, because our acharyas were very intelligent people. So they understood this issues. And then they have given the proper lifestyles for that. So as all of you know that aging is inevitable. No one can stop. Even no one wants to become old, but still we can't stop. So what we can do is with certain changes, with the help of Ayurveda, we can make this phase of life more easy. So as I explained, old age is specifically, there are three doshas in Ayurveda: Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So out of these three doshas, Vata is the dominant dosha. When you are a child, when small kids, in that age is dominated by Kapha dosha. In young age, that time period is dominated by Pitta dosha. And after 50, that time period is dominated by Vata dosha. So overall, Vata dosha is very, very high. And if someone is born with a Vata dominance, then definitely he is going to suffer more. And this Vata dosha, when Vata dosha increases, then it affects the Rasadhatu. So the Rasadhatu, that is the main nutritious juice which comes from the, by after taking food, it also gets diminished. So because of that, patient feels weak, undernourished, no energy, no more lethargy, lack of sleep, all those problems start coming, dryness in the body. So for that, all of these issues, Ayurveda offers this Rasayana Chikitsa. So this is a special branch of Ayurveda. And it specifically, if you follow the regimen which is given, then our vata problem will come down. Like pain will come down, constipation will come down, insomnia, if you are not getting sleep for longer hours, then that also can be reduced. So we have to understand vata. So how vata functions, what are its qualities, that we have to see. Along with that, there are certain basic things which are mentioned by our acharyas. So all those basic things together, when they are balanced, then you are free from the diseases. So what are those basic things? First is the three doshas, that is vata, pitta and kapha. Then seven dhatus, that is rasa, rakta, mamsa, medha, asthi, majja, shukra. And three malas, that is sweat, urine and fecal matter. Then indriyas, all the sense organs and soul. So all those, with the cooperation of all these factors, our body functions well. And when there is any kind of imbalance in any of these, then our body shows diseases. So the three doshas, vata, pitta, kapha, and our body is made up of five elements. Pancha Mahabhuta, we call it. So vata is called as ether, pitta is a fire factor, and kapha is a water. So in this, certain pancha mahabhutas are dominant. In a vata dosha, ether or a space is a dominant pancha mahabhut. In a pitta, the fire factor is a more dominant, along with little water factor. And in a kapha dosha, water and earth, that is also called as a bhumi. So these two pancha mahabhuta are dominant. So if three doshas are imbalanced, then they cause imbalance of all these elements also. So we have to treat them as per the vitiation. So as I mentioned, seven dhatus, rasa means a nutritious factor, rakta means blood, mamsa means muscles, medha means fatty tissues, asthi means bones, majja means nervine tissues, and shukra means sperm or ovum, are also called as a vitality of the body. So all these seven dhatus, if they are properly nourished, they form the immune system. So when if they are strong enough, then definitely they help to fight against the diseases, and they try to help to balance the doshas also. Then three malas are explained, that is a purisham, that means fecal matter, mutram, that is a urine, and svedam, that means sweat. So they, what is their role? They throw out the toxins from the body. So three malas, actually, they also form a supportive system to the body. And when proper nourishment is done, they are thrown out of the body with the toxins. So if doshas are imbalanced, then also you get diseased. If your dhatus are reduced or diminished, then body's immunity becomes weak, and then also you get disease. So in the aging process, basically the first dhatu, that is rasa dhatu, becomes weak. So therefore you get the problems, and that's why you have to treat basically this vata dosha. So as I already explained, the dominance of dosha up to 12 years, the kapha dosha dominant. That's why in the children, if you see, they get more cold and cough, all these kind of issues, because that is related with the kapha dosha. The young age, that is from 12 years to 40 years, pitta dosha dominant. So that's why in young age, if you see acidity problems or digestion related problems, or acne on the face, or hormonal imbalances, all those things are very common. Graying of the hair is also nowadays, if pitta is imbalanced, it's very common. So that is because of the dominance of the pitta. So we have to change our lifestyle, change our food habits as per our age also. Everyone must know their dosha. That's we are doing through Prakriti analysis. But those who don't know, at least they should understand through these ages, that now I'm in this age group. That means overall pitta dominance will be there. If I'm in a small age group, the overall kapha dominance will be there. And when I'll be like after 50, after 45, like that, vata dosha dominance will be there. So you can see vata dosha is it causes dryness, stiffness, sound in the joints. You can see knee joint, they make some sound. Shoulder also, they make some sound. Then hair also starts falling. Dryness of the hair, hair become more frizzy. So treatments means not only taking medicine, but our daily routine. Ayurveda, it explains about the Dinacharya and Rutucharya. Dinacharya means daily regimen and Rutucharya means seasonal regimen. So whenever, if you follow this daily regimen or if you follow seasonal regimen, because every 3 months the season is changing, and as per that you also must change your food habits, you must change your activities. So that is also very important. So that is also a kind of a medicine only. So with that your body becomes more strong and it doesn't easily get affected by the diseases or the changes in the climate. So Rutucharya is also very vital. And then lifestyle, like food habits, what food you are taking. Then sleep, how much you are sleeping, that is also important. Exercises are very important. And then above all these things is your thought process. So because with your thoughts, your hormones also get affected. So that is also one of the very important factor and should not be neglected. Apart from above specific Ayurvedic remedies, which are good, which are available for old age problem. So we have to follow all these seasonal regimen and daily regimen. And then along with that, if we take some medicines or follow certain therapies, or you take few therapies, then definitely your old age will not be as much as you are suffering. So we will see what are the common problems which a person suffers in the old age. First and very common is joint pains. If you see, almost 90% old age people suffer from the joint related problems. So because of this joint related problems, in Ayurveda it is said that there is a question. Please tell more about premature graying and what diet to follow. And then another question is what age is considered old age? So after 40, our acharyas has said that after 50, the age is considered as a old age. And then that is the initial phase of old age. In society, if you see 60 and 70 in advanced old age, you can see the all these diseases. And premature graying is all because of excess pitta. I think yesterday's or day before yesterday also I gave like if premature graying is there, then first thing you have to see either is there any hereditary in the family. If your mother or father has started graying earlier, there are chances that you may also start graying earlier. Second thing is if on the top, if you are taking the food which is more of a pungent, spicy, oily, citrus, or like not citrus but sour things like tamarind, tomatoes, all those which increases pitta. If your lifestyle is more stressful, if your food habits are irregular, if you are eating more junk food, if you are constipated, or if your digestion is not good, then definitely that affects excess, that causes excess pitta, and with that you start graying of the hair. So in that, Virechanam is the treatment which we offer. And like certain daily Sadhya Virechanam also can be taken. For example, a simple medicine like Triphala on a daily basis at bedtime can be taken. Then hair packs can be done. Certain medicines are there which helps in a graying. For example, Bringaraj, Jatamansi, Amla, all those things if you include. So that is all comes under anti-pitta diet. So that can be taken more. With that, you will reduce the speed of a graying. And if you are very young, then definitely you will start getting black hair also. It takes time. You have to follow this regimen for longer period, maybe 2 to 3 months. And certain anti-pitta medicines are also there. If you take all these medications, definitely graying of hair will come down. So now we were discussing about this joint pains. So because of vata, when vata increases, it affects the asthi dhatu, that means bones, which causes the joint pain. So Ayurveda offers certain specific medicines. I'm just telling you the names of the medicine, but I will suggest you to take it under the advice or after the expert opinion of your Ayurveda doctor. So medicines which we suggest in vata disorder or a joint pain is Trayodashanga Bhubulu, which is a very good medicine for joint related problems or when there is a degeneration. Then Maharasnadi is one of the herb that helps in a degenerative related joint problems. Then Dashamula Kwata, Dashamula, that means 10 roots. So there are 10 different roots which are mentioned in Ayurveda as a vata pacifying. The best vata pacifying medicine is a Dashamula. So Dashamula Rishtam or Dashamula Kwatam, if you take on a regular basis, the excess vata which is causing you problem will definitely come down. Then because joint problem can also happen because of the diminishing of dhatu, so that's why we suggest to have a Ashwagandha Churnam or Ashwagandha Rishtam. This is the very common medicine given for the after 50s, and it helps a lot mentally also, physically also, and to strengthening the joint also. So Ashwagandha is the best rasayan, can be taken almost by any type of a dosha. Then what Ayurveda suggests is Abhyangam, that means oil massage or oil application. So wherever you are getting pain, wherever the sound is coming, specifically knee joint pain, if you see shoulder pains, some small joints also, some patient they get pain in the small joints also. So wherever you are getting this joint pain, you can just apply Karpura Tailam. Karpura Tailam with the gingerly oil, that means sesame seed oil. You can mix both the oils and you can massage affected part twice a day. It should be warm because vata is cold in nature. So whatever treatment we do for vata dosha is a warm treatment. So oil should be warm. So you have to apply that oil twice a day to the affected area. Then consume 10 grams of ginger daily. So this ginger helps in a digestion problem also, and it helps to expel the excess toxins from the body. So that's why for a vata treatment, we suggest to have you can have ginger either in vegetable, by adding in the vegetables, or you can have a ginger juice also in small amount. So like that, you can consume ginger every day along with your lunch. Then Tripala Churnam is a very good rasayan, another rasayan, like Ashwagandha is also rasayan, like that Tripala is also very good rasayan. So can be taken 1 spoon Tripala, that means 5 grams with a 200 ml of warm water for 4 to 6 months. So this is a specifically good remedy for those who are getting digestion related problems, or if they are not feeling fresh. So it's a kind of good rasayana treatment. And it will also help in hair fall. It will strengthen your body internally. It will improve your immunity. Then comes constipation. Constipation is also very, very common nowadays. And it is in Ayurveda, it is mentioned as a root cause for many diseases. So that's why if you go to any Ayurveda doctor, first he will say whether your stomach is getting clean or intestines are getting clean, or whether you are getting constipation, because that is mentioned as the root cause of all the diseases. So constipation is caused because of kapha goes down, and excess pitta also, kapha and pitta goes down and vata increases. So that's why you get constipation. So for that, what you have to do is you consume at least 4 to 5 liters of water, specifically those who are vata or a pitta dominant persons. Those who are kapha, they can take little less water also, no problem. But other people, at least minimum 3 to 4 liters you must consume water, specifically in a summer season, so you must consume, and it should be warm. Whenever you are drinking water, it should be warm. Then you take cooked food, because raw food increases more vata. So raw food is not for those who are vata dominant person or old age, because already your digestive fire becomes very weak. So raw food can be taken only by those who have a very strong appetite, strong metabolism and strong digestion. So those specifically for pitta dominant person, we suggest to have raw foods. But those who are vata dominant, they should either, if they are taking salads or maybe like a raw food, they should at least steam the that food and then have. It should be warm while eating. Then taking ragi, jawar, bajra will help in a constipation. So these are all fibrous food and millets, and they are easily expelled out through the body. Then again, triphala also will help in this condition. Take 5 gram of triphala with a warm water before going to bed. Then memory issue. So if you see our mothers or mother-in-laws or grandmothers, if you see, they have this tendency. If you ask them where you kept the thing, they don't remember. Even one day before also, if they have kept anything, they don't remember. They keep on forgetting. Sometimes they just open the fridge and then they forget why I opened the fridge. So all these things are very common. Sometimes they keep their specs somewhere and they just keep on finding throughout, they keep on searching throughout the house. Where is my skept? So all these are like because of the memory. And why this memory loss happens? Because excess vata is causing degenerative problem. So for that, we have to give certain things which will enhance or which will boost up the memory, which will nourish the brain cells. So in that, what are the things which you can include is a Brahmi Ghritam, very commonly available in the market. Brahmi Ghritam or a Brahmi Leham also can be taken. Then another famous medicine is called Sarasvatarishtam. So this Sarasvatarishtam, generally we suggest even for kids also, specifically during exam times and all, we suggest so they can remain positive and they can memorize the things which they are learning. So it is a very good memory tonic. Then Shankha Pushpi is for specifically for those people who are a pitta dominant person, those who have more fire in their body or more digestive fire, like those people, in them Shankha Pushpi is advisable. Ashwagandha is again because it calms down your nervous system, so it also helps in a good memory. And along with that, you can take a glass of a cow milk. So only Sarasvatarishtam, if you are taking, don't take it with milk, you just take it with a warm water. But other things you can have with the milk, specifically Ashwagandha, Brahmi Leham, if they are taken with the milk, they gives good effect. Then dental problems. If you see, many old age people, half of their teeth are gone only. Sometimes some of the people, if they don't take care of their health in their earlier age, their teeth fall very easily and very early age, like before old age only. So it is also a very common problem. So clean the teeth twice a day with a triphala using finger. So generally what we are doing, we are using toothpaste or something like some Ayurvedic or maybe Colgate or all those things. But triphala is a very good medicine. In multiple problems, you can use triphala. So triphala helps in a strengthening of your gums. So those who are getting any bleeding from the gums or gingivitis or gums are very weak, they can't hold the teeth. That's why the teeth fall. So this triphala will help in strengthening of the gums. So when gums get strengthened well, then there will be less chances of falling the teeth. Then you can even gargle. If someone finds difficult because a triphala is little sour, and if someone is having very sensitive teeth, so for them, they can't rub a triphala on the teeth and gums. they can gargle with Trifala Kashaya. So one glass of water, in that you add one spoon of a Trifala powder, boil it, make it lukewarm and gargle. Then another oil is also available called as Iri Medadi Tailam, which is also very good medicine. So you can just, this is a medicated oil, you can just take a few drops of oil and massage on your gums and teeth. So that is also a good remedy, well-known remedy, well-tested remedy for the gum strengthening. Then sleeplessness is also very, very common. So this is also because of the vitiated vata only. So if you see, if you check old age people, they are always awake. But sometimes they sleep also, but they don't feel that they have slept enough. They feel that I'm not getting enough sleep and I'm still awake. Externally, if you see, they will be sleeping, but they don't get the satisfaction that I have slept well. So in this condition, Shankhapushpi syrup also helps. Ashwagandha churnam with the milk or ashwagandha tablets with the milk can be taken at bedtime. It gives good sleep. Jatamansi is one of the herb. So Jatamansi kwath induces very good sleep. Jatamansi is specifically for those people who have hypertension, and because of high blood pressure, they don't get proper sleep. They get headache, all this kind of. So in such a people, we suggest to have a Jatamansi kwath. And it reduces the blood pressure also, and it gives good sleep. Brisk walking for 12 to 15 minutes a day also helps. It improves the circulation. And dinner at 7 p.m. and warm milk at 9 p.m. induces good sleep. So all those things, if followed well, then you get good sleep. Then there are certain therapies also which we suggest. For example, Shirodhara. So Shirodhara taken for 7 days also induces good sleep. It helps you to reduce anxiety, restlessness, hypertension, headache, sleeplessness, all those problems. We suggest this Shirodhara treatment. Then immunodeficiency. So if you see, as age advances, people become more susceptible for the various kind of diseases. That's why if you see during COVID time also, it affected the old age people more. They got the infections very faster as compared to children and young age people. Why? Because of this immunodeficiency. So old age, the immunity is weak. So that can be also strengthened by strengthening or improving the immunity of the dhatus. So there are good immunomodulators. So that's why during this COVID time, Chyawanprash became Chyawanprash or Agastya Rasayanam. All these type of Rasayanam became very famous because they improve your immunity. So those who are taking Chyawanprash or Agastya, those who are getting respiratory problems recurrently, for them we suggest Agastya Rasayanam. It is also another kind of Chyawanprash only. And otherwise, even normal Chyawanprash also can be taken 1 to 2 spoons at bedtime with a warm milk. Then another herb is called as a Vasanta Kusumakara. So it is also very good immunomodulator and it strengthens all the dhatus. But make sure that whenever you start all these medications, take guidance from your Ayurveda doctor. Ashwagandha can be started. I think from day one, I'm explaining the importance of Ashwagandha and Shatavari, which are very good herbs. And you can see once you start all these, start taking all these medications, you will feel the difference in your body. You will feel I'm getting strengthened, my immunity is improving, my focus is improving. So Ashwagandha can be taken on a daily basis. Then another medicine is called as Siddha Makaradhvaja. It is also a herbo mineral medicine, you can say. And it also helps in strengthening. If there is a lot of a degenerative issue, in that cases, Siddha Makaradhvaj helps a lot. Then oil massage, that is a Shastriya Taila Abhyanga. That means oil massage 2 times a week, because Vata, the treatment is oil. So that's why if you are doing any oil massages, that will also strengthen your immunity and strengthen your body metabolism. Circulation also will get improved. And then Vajikarana. Vajikarana means aphrodisiac medicines. In that also, Ashwagandha is one of the main and common medicines. can be taken, which also improves the immunity. Then comes digestion. So digestion is also, it reduces, so digestive fire reduces in the old age. So it is better if someone is suffering on everyday basis, they are not getting any appetite, then for them we suggest they can have a shunti powder with a ghee. So shunti means dry ginger, so dry ginger powder and ghee. So 1 to 2 pinches of a dry ginger powder and 1/2 teaspoon of a cow ghee, and in that if you add a pinch of a rock salt, and you have to take it with the first morsel, then you will see your appetite is increasing. Then you can consume ginger. Ginger also very good appetizer. You can have ginger dalchini. That is, dalchini means cinnamon. So ginger, cinnamon, and tulsi. All those three things you can have. You can consume in a tea form, which will also help in a digestion. Then at least once in a week you should do phala upavasa. That means you should stay on the fruits only. That also helps to improve the digestion. And dinner before 7. So early dinner is very important in old age, because as the day goes, as the day advances, the night starts, your digestive fire becomes very, very weak. So that's why you have to start taking your dinner before 7. Here is one question, that can Triphala be used as an alternative to Dabur Lal paste? Can a person of old age use Triphala only skipping Dabur Lal paste? See, if you are brushing your teeth with the Dabur Lal paste, you can brush, but this is an extra addition which you have to do. So it's not an alternative, but it is an addition, you can say. You have to either gargle with a Triphala, or you can massage after your brushing. There is a question, I'm 22 years, can I take ashwagandha daily? Yes, you can take ashwagandha. There is no harm in taking ashwagandha on daily basis. There is a question, how long can ashwagandha be taken and by which prakriti? Ashwagandha can be taken for a longer period, even 1 or 2 years also it can be taken. It doesn't harm anyone. It is the safest medicine, and it is good for any kind of prakriti. Only the things, doses will be different as per age or as per your prakriti, but ashwagandha can be taken, no problem. Can Triphala be used to clean teeth and gums for kids too? Definitely Triphala can be used, but for kids you make them gargle with the Triphala. So Triphala quath can be prepared, and after their brushing they can gargle. It becomes very easy because kids are very fussy. If they don't like the taste, Triphala has little astringent taste. If they don't like taste, then they won't use it for rubbing. So you can just give the water and make sure that they gargle with this water. Triphala after food or before food? It all depends upon what problem you are having. If it is for weight loss, then it should be taken on empty stomach in the morning. If it is for constipation, then it can be taken after food. Can we get PPT of yesterday and today? Abhyangam can be done by anyone. Yes, PPT I will try to share, like how we shared on the first day, same. And then Abhyangam can be done by anyone except those who are getting cough, cold, fever, and those who have a swelling on their body, they should avoid the Abhyangam. Otherwise, everyone must do Abhyangam. See, there is a question, what is the difference between citrus and sour? Actually, citrus, all sour things have a citrus, citric acid basically, but not all sour things are will work as a alkaline in nature. Few will work as a acidic. So that's why instead of using citrus word, I used sour word, because I wanted specifically mention about tamarind and tomatoes, which increases. Other citrus things like sweet lime, oranges, lemon, if they are taking, they work as an alkaline to the body. So we don't consider them as a anti-pitta, we don't consider them that they will increase the pitta, but sour things, specifically tamarind and tomatoes, may increase the pitta. what age is considered old age? I think video is clear for everyone, right? So I have answered all the questions, I think. Can Ashwagandha help for the people with a migraine? See, basically, first we have to rule out what is the cause of the migraine. If it is an excess pitta, if it is excess vata, all those things should be ruled out and treated properly. Then after that, as a maintenance, you can have a Ashwagandha. Can we take Tripal and Ashwagandha? No, you have to keep a separate time. Ashwagandha you can take immediately after food. Tripala can be taken later after 1 hour. My mom is 52 and she gets perspiration many times during the day. What to do? See, that is because of excess pitta, and 52, that means either menopause or perimenopause or postmenopause. So if there is a menopause related issue, then Ashwagandha can be given, no problem. It helps a lot in all these conditions. So 2 tablets of Ashwagandha can be given along with the milk at bedtime in the menopause. That is coming. We are having a few slides on the menopause also, because yesterday I could not explain details about menopause. So that's why I'll be sharing little more detail than yesterday about the menopause, because that also comes in a old age. So I explained about digestion, and there are few digestives also which can be taken. So in that, Himvashtaka Churnam is a very good digestive. You can have half spoon of a Himvashtaka, mix it, you can mix it with cow ghee, little cow ghee, and take it as a first morsel in your food. Bhaskara Lavana Churnam also can be taken. It can be taken either before food or in between meals. Means half of the meal is over, then in between, in that you take 1 spoon of a Bhaskara Lavan and then finish rest of the meal. That also helps in improving the digestion. Then there are tablets called as Agni Tundivati, which are very good for the digestion. And Jiraka, that means a cumin seed, or a fennel, that means sauf. So fennel and Jiraka are very good appetizers. And generally those who don't get good appetite, or in the patients where we want to boost up their metabolism, for such a people, we suggest a home remedy that you prepare a cumin seed water or a fennel seed water. You just take 1 liter of water, add 1 spoon of a cumin or a fennel, boil it nicely, and whenever you are thirsty, you drink that water. So in the first half of the day, whenever you are thirsty, you finish this medicated water. And after that, if you are thirsty, then you can drink normal water. So it works as a very good appetizer. It is a very good, it increases the metabolism of the body. Those who are getting digestive problems, acidity problems, no appetite or low appetite, for them also, this is a very good remedy. Then it is better to have vegetable soup with a pepper 1 hour before food. That also works as a very good appetizer. Then drink a sip of lukewarm water while taking food. That helps in a digestion. It improves the digestive fire, and it also helps in a absorption of the food. Then comes menopause. Menopause is also one of the old age issue in the females. Yesterday, I could not take it more detail about it. But basically, I would like to explain menopause is a kind of a unique experience faced by females when their reproductive age is over. And you can see there are multiple medicines also which helps in the menopause. So it is a female goes through a lot of physiological changes also and psychological changes also. So that's why we have to take care of this time period. That is a very important phase, and it is a phase of a transition from a pitta dominance to the vata dominance. So we have to see what are the symptoms which a female feels during the menopause. If a female is a vata dominant by birth, then she may get following symptoms like a panic attacks and fears, inner instability or nervousness can be seen. depression is a very commonly found. Then intense emotional fluctuations are there. Insomnia is a very common sudden onset of a dry, intense heat. Then feeling of a cold and chill, like they may feel cold in between inside their body. Nerve tachycardia, vaginal dryness, dry skin, constipation, then loss of elasticity of the skin, pain in the joints, osteoporosis, decreased sexual desire and migraine. These are the most common. Many of them can be seen a vata dominant female. Then those who are pitta dominant female, those who are from their birth, if they are pitta dominant female, then in such a female, you see, they are very hot and moist sweats, sudden sweats. Then they wake up in the night because of the sweat. Their body is profusely sweat. You can see clothes are wet. Then sensation of intense heat under their skin. They feel there is a lot of heat under my skin. On touch also, they are very hot. Emotions are also red hot. They become very, very angry with the small, small things. You can see those females who are pitta dominant. If they are there in your house, you can easily make out that now she has become irritable and angry with the small, small things. Sometimes without any reason also they become angry. Then there is a propensity to discuss any nonsense. That also you must have noticed if you have aged females around you. That is because of a pitta, and sometimes it could be because of a vata dominance also. And what are the discomforts? If they feel is the heat attacks with lot of sweat, very strong internal heat sensation, intense night sweat, wrath and strong genius. Then sudden diarrhea also can be found without any reason. Hemorrhoids are very common. Susceptible to any comment, that is also is seen in a pitta dominant female. If you are not talking about them also, they feel that they are talking about me, they are talking about bad things about me. So they just start argumenting about it, and very intense menstrual bleeding also can be seen. It could be irregular also, but that is only for the time, small short phase, it automatically stops. But if the bleeding is heavy, then you may have to treat it. Then rashes are there, acne or herpes zoster can also be seen, vaginitis, intolerance to the sun, high blood pressure and tension headache are very common discomforts which are found in a pitta woman in a menopause phase. Then kapha dosha, if a female is a kapha dominant, then in her menopause phase she may feel weight gain, specifically abdominal weight starts gaining, heaviness and lethargy in the body and mind, inertia and permanent fatigue. Always they will say I'm tired. Then fluid retention, you can see their face becomes puffy. Hands and legs also you can see water starts retaining. The clothes which they wear becomes more tight. Then general swelling and heaviness in the legs is very commonly found. Sudden heats, they also feel some heat interruption, but it won't be that much unpleasant like a pitta females feel. But they may feel little sweat also. Sadness and depression is very, very commonly found in a kapha dosha dominant females. So what happens? They become more isolated. They don't want to mix in the society. They don't want to go out. They just want to stay in their home, of their own. No one should be disturbing them. They just become more, feel inner loneliness basically. So that is also a phase. If you treat them, if you give them good rasayana medicines, definitely they will come out of this phase. So what are the discomforts like weight gain, heaviness, lethargy, apathy, inertia, constant fatigue, fluid retention. Apart from these, fungal infections, very slow and heavy digestion. They don't feel like eating only. Sluggish digestion is also found. And depression and sadness are major discomfort. So what can be done? See, basically oil is the best medicine for vata. Ghee is the best medicine for pitta. And honey is the best medicine for the kapha. So it is either oil can be either internally or externally. So we give certain, those who are vata dominant female, in them we give certain oil capsules or oil to drink. And externally also oil massages are suggested. There is a kind of a panchakarma treatment called as a basti or a vasti, where we are giving oil or milk enemas. This is for specifically for vata and pitta dominant females. If in that menopause phase, perimenopause, premenopause, postmenopausal phase, if they once in a year, if they do these Vasti sessions, then definitely their symptoms will get relieved and they can easily go through this menopause phase. Then another technique is a warm castor oil can be poured on the navel region. That is the main site of a Vata, and a clockwise massage can be done in that area so that the Vata will come down. It is also suggested in the painful periods also. It helps to reduce the pain. Then what are the herbs which you have to add is Shatavari, Ashwagandha and Shilajit. Shatavari is, it has its own balancing nature. It is very good nourishing tonic for the uterus. And then Ashwagandha, as I'm explaining glories about Ashwagandha so many times, it helps to balancing the hormones, it strengthens, it is very good for insomnia, it's very good for the joint related problems. So many benefits of Ashwagandha are seen. Then Shilajit is also one of the medicine. It is a mineral, herbo mineral medicine, you can say. It enhances the energy, reduces Vata, and improves the muscle strength. Actually, Shilajit is famous for another reason. People use Shilajit for aphrodisiac reason, which is very good, but still Shilajit has other good effects also. So actually it enhances, it is also Rasayana. It enhances energy, it reduces Vata, and improves the muscle strength. So those who are getting cramps in their legs or pain in the legs, severe pain, for them we suggest Shilajit. Shilajit is also available in a liquid form or in a tablet form. So Shilajit liquids, one or two drops every day with the milk, helps internal strength. Then licorice is also one of the wonder herbs in Ayurveda, one of the rasayan herbs apart from Shatavari and Ashwagandha. Licorice helps in a menopause. Basically, it balances all the dosha. And because licorice is a little sweet in taste, it is a very good pitta pacifying. So that's why if a female who is getting hot flushes, if she takes licorice water, then her hot flushes reduces up to 80%. It also makes your bones strong. So licorice water, how it, you can prepare it, so you take 2 liters of water, you add 1 spoon of a licorice, boil it nicely, and whenever you are thirsty, you drink this water. It is very good for throat related problems. It protects you from your cold and cough related issues also. For younger kids or small kids, we are giving licorice to chew or with honey and ghee for a sore throat or cough related issues also. So licorice is a one of the wonder herb. It's very good pitta pacifying or anti-pitta herb. So menopause specifically, you have to make your menopause happy and a positive experience. Watch your thoughts. It's time to be focused on more inner things than external things. You can laugh a lot, make time for yourself, stay connected, stay in the moment, because it's a transition phase of hormones. So more you become anxious, more you become stressed out, more you become nervous, it is going to affect you badly more. So if you just try to come out of it, try to be social, try to get connected with your older friends, try to cultivate older habits which you have left because of your busy life. Now it's time to retire. So make time for yourself. Then your menopause will become more positive experiences. You know, changes are inevitable, but not always controllable. But what can be controlled is how you manage, react to, and work through the change process. Then panchakarma. What is a panchakarma in the geriatrics? Basically, they have all these things. What I said, they forget. So all those things are very common. Joint problems are also very common. So that's why rasayana or a rejuvenation treatment we suggest in this condition. So this is the rasayana or rejuvenation treatment. It's the kind of a panchakarma. There are certain other panchakarmas also, like a vasti, nasyam, virechanam, vamana, and raktamokshana. So they all are dependent upon what condition you are having or what are the symptoms which you are having. As per that, your doctor chooses which treatment to be done. But definitely all these treatments help a lot in this phase of a life. So diseases of aging, you can see it's diabetes or hypertension or joint pain. So Ayurveda has a very good permanent solutions to it. but only you have to find a good doctor and do the proper panchakarma treatment. You can see here in the picture there are two good therapies specifically for the hypertension or memory loss or sleeplessness. So the first one is a shirovasti. It is a procedure of retaining medicated oil on the head in a flexible container beamed over hair. So you can see here in the picture, the first picture here, the therapist is pouring the oil on the head. You have to retain this oil for 30 minutes, and it is a procedure which calms the mind and it enhances the intellect. Then another procedure you can see, it is a shirodhara. I think everyone must be knowing shirodhara. It's a very famous treatment. So it's a medicated oil or a milk or a buttermilk or a medicated decoction which is poured on the forehead. So it induces soothing effect to the head, and it reduces the stress, and it also induces the good sleep. So you can see here in the picture, this is the second one, is a shirodhara picture. It's a very soothing and calming treatment. Those who have experienced it must have a good experience about it. It's a very good treatment for the buddhi and smriti, or cognition and memory. So anti-aging medicines or the rasayana medicines, what are the herbs? We'll see. Brahmi is one of the famous herb. It is specifically for the intellect, memory, all those things. Then amalaki, it's for overall body immunity. Ashwagandha is overall body immunity, body immunizer. Shatavari is also very good specifically for the females. Then Shankapushpi is a good brain tonic. Vacha is also very good herb for the memory and brain tonic only. Tripala is for digestion related problems, or if you have weight gain or excess pitta in your body, Tripala is very good. And Suvarna Basmam, it's a herbal mineral preparations made up of a gold, which helps to boost up your memory also, and it also improves your immunity. So what is the effect of all these rasayana drugs? It sharpens the memory, it improves the mental activity and intelligence, it increases the resistance and immunity, it is anti-aging, it also improves metabolism, and it also helps in a maintenance of optimum strength of the body and senses, maintain health and promote longevity of the life, and rejuvenate all your cells. Then lifestyle in this old age, stay physically active with the regular exercises. So regular exercises are a must. Stay socially active with your friends and family, because they will help you emotionally. Eat healthy and well-balanced diet. Get the sleep, get proper sleep. How much your body needs, at least 6 to 7 hours you have to sleep. Enjoy each and every day. This is your retired life, so you have to enjoy and be happy with the everyday moments. Then diet style, take simple and easily digestible food. Choose high fibers food, so we'll get rid of constipation issues. Drink fluids throughout the day. So you may see, basically in this age, some people may feel less thirsty, but still your body needs water. So you need to hydrate your body with different fluids. It's not just water, but you can have juices or herbal teas and all those things. What are the things which you should avoid during the old age? Is cold food items, cheese, dried food items, then five whites. Which are those five whites? They are white poisons, refined sugar, refined salt, refined flour, pasteurized cow milk, and refined white rice. So all those five whites we have to avoid. And then old food items, like stale food items we have to avoid. Then there are certain rasayan, well-prepared rasayans are also there, which is a ajastrika rasayan. So this is a medicine which protects all your dhatus. So one has to consume milk, curd and ghee, all those things, which will balance all the three doshas. Instead of curd, I suggest you take more buttermilk, cow milk and ghee, which is very good for the excellent old age problems. Then naimittika rasayana, this is a procedure is adopted during the convalescence after disease. you have to maintain the dhatus that are imbalanced through your proper food and lifestyle. Then kamya rasayana, as per the need, it is a specific medicines you have to take, and then which will improve the longevity, memory and appetite. Then achara rasayana is also mentioned. Achara rasayana means with your activities, like because of the stress you face more problems. So yoga, dhyana, meditation, all those things will help. Along with that, you can control all your kam, krodh, moh, mad, matsar, and which will help you to reduce, get rid from the stress. Take care of your body. It's the only place you have to live in. So adopt Ayurveda, attain holistic health to make your old age as a gold age. Thank you for your patient listening. And then we'll go for a few question answers. What anti-aging practice can be performed to prevent early aging, like prevention of a graying hair, dry skin, and anti-aging skincare practice at a young age? Okay, anti-aging skincare practice at a young age, and how to reverse graying of hair, or how to treat gray hair in Ayurveda. This question is coming repeatedly. Yesterday also I explained graying of hair can be reversed if you are young. Anti-pitta diet is the diet which you have to follow. The food which is more of a sweet taste, more of an astringent and bitter taste can be taken. So it reduces pitta. Then cow ghee also can be included, which also reduces pitta. Trifala helps to reduce pitta. Anti-aging practices you have to do every day. Abhyangam, that means oil massages are must, which also helps. Then getting up early in the morning, doing some exercises or pranayama will help. Oil massages, feet massages are very important. And then in between, whenever you get time, you do certain panchakarma therapies like vamana, vireshanam, aravasti, any of these seasonal therapies are there, which will help you to remain young for longer period. There is a question that my mother is 78 and has a chronic pain in the right arm. She doesn't like to visit doctors. How can I help her? See, basically, after a certain age, most of the females, they become more stubborn. That is also abstinent nature of the vata, basically. So you can just do certain, if there is no swelling on the right arm, you can do some oil massages like Dhanvantaram Thaila or Karpuradi Thailam. Or if there is a history of a trauma, then Murivenna oil also can be used for the oil massage. And then use warm oil for the massages. Then you can steam that area, or you can just dip a towel in hot water and foment that area. And then along with that, you can start giving her ashwagandha. Definitely, she will improve. What diet or practice to do if a person feels swelling or inflamed pain in ovaries and near area during her menstruation period for 3 to 4 days only? I think we have covered this topic yesterday. It was Rajasphala Paricharya. So whenever when the menstruation period is going on, we have to take the food which is more of a milk, rice, ghee, and barley. So all those things, if you take more, along with that, if you are getting pain, then you can include Ashwagandha Rishtam during these 3-4 days. It will help specifically in the if you are getting pain or any inflammation is there. This diet can be done. And then you should not exert too much. Don't take a lot of stress of the work and all. You can isolate yourself for 3-4 days and take rest and keep focusing on positive things, because hormones also play a very important role in this time period. PCOD solution. And see, PCOD is basically, it is a lifestyle induced disorder. Sometimes it could be hereditary also. If your mother or sister, anyone in the family is having, then you may get PCOD. But still, I will say it is because of the hormonal imbalance, and certain help can be done with a proper lifestyle. Avoid junk food, avoid hot, pungent, spicy food. Take very simple, light food, easily digestible, homemade food. Stay away from the stress. And then PCOD actually can be treated with Ayurvedic medicines also. Yes, find a good doctor and start taking medicines for the PCOD. Some home remedy I will suggest you, like you can have at least one, twice or thrice a week, you can have horse gram soup, which is very good in the PCOD related issues. So horse gram is a kulatha in Hindi. So you can check in any grocery shop and you will get a horse gram there. So prepare soup out of it, or prepare some, you can cook it nicely with lots of water, and then you can have it twice or thrice. Can you suggest remedy on a scanty period, dry hair in terms of a foot or oil treatment? I'm having with Pitta Prakriti and do face Vata problems sometimes. See, if there is a scanty period, that means we have to check whether you have any PCOD related kind of a thing, or if your hemoglobin is less, then also you may get scanty period. So you have to check in that perspective. If you have a PCOD, you have to find a good doctor, and you can treat it with good Ayurvedic medicines. If it is because of a less hemoglobin, then you can include food items like jaggery, beetroot, dates, spinach, all those which have high iron content can be taken more often, so that your hemoglobin will come up, and with that you may get good period. Then dry hair in terms of food or oil, so you can, for the hair, you can have, if it is a dry hair, you can have lots of seed in your diet, like sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, all those things. And the oil, I'll suggest Neeli Vringadi is one of the good oil for the hair issues. So basically, oil is the treatment. There is a question, IBS can be cured. See, IBS is a very stubborn disease, you can say. It has a connection with your thought process also. So that's why you can, I'll say it may not be get cured completely, but you can still stay with it happily. Because when you learn to manage it, then IBS can be controlled very well. But for IBS, you have to follow strict diet regimen, because diet has a very strong role in IBS. Could you please share remedy for continuous pain in hands region below shoulder and other limbs, like maybe in bones majorly? First thing you have to see is if there is any kind of a swelling on that area. If there is a swelling, then you may have to take certain medications to reduce the swelling, like Punarnava, Bokshura, something like that, or maybe Rasnati, Gugulu or something. When the swelling comes down, then you can do oil massages whenever pain is there. So Dhanvantaram oil or Karpuradi oil is very good. Internal oils also can be taken. We are using generally Kshirabala oil or Gandha Tailam, like that. You have to check whether there is any trauma or any fracture. As per that, you have to treat it. Please suggest remedies for Pitta headache. I have intense headache with vomiting. If it is a case of a like intense headache and vomiting, I will suggest if you can go for a one Panchakarma session of a Virechanam, and then after that, if you take start taking anti-Pitta food and medicine, definitely your migraine or Pitta related headache will come down. And along with that, the home remedies which you can have is, you can have a coriander seed water or a cumin seed water. As I mentioned, 1 liter of water. In that you have to add one teaspoon of cumin seed, 1 teaspoon of coriander seed. I'm facing some interest issues, internet issues. Please, can you share the recording? Yeah, actually we will share the PPTs in the group. I'm 45 and have reached menopause because of my medication for breast cancer. This is tamoxifen. I feel all about symptoms, but I'm concerned about my weight gain, though my diet hasn't changed. if your weight gain is because of your medications and all those treatments which you have gone through, it will take time to reduce the weight, but focus on the diet. Take lots of cooked salads, you can say, cooked food, like a beetroot or carrots, all those things, spinach, all those things can be included more. Take cumin seed water every day. Take light meals in the dinner, like soups, vegetable soups, or moong soups, sprouted moong, all those things, if you take, include more in your diet, definitely you will reduce the weight. Or there are certain strenuous panchakarma procedures also, but if your health is, or if your strength is not strong, then we may not be able to do all those treatments. But at least Trifala can be taken at bedtime, one teaspoon. So that also will help. Or maybe on empty stomach morning, you can have one teaspoon of a Trifala along with a one cup of a warm water. Hare Krishna, I'm 46 years and I'm very thin, not able to gain weight. Please suggest. So if you're not able to put on weight, that means you may be a Vata dominant person, because Vata dominant person, for them it is very difficult to put on weight. So oil massages will help in this condition. And internally also, I will suggest if you can take ashwagandha with a warm milk for a longer period. Then certain internal, if your digestion is good, then certain internal ghee also we suggest, like vidaryadi ghritam or shatavaryadi ghritam or shatavari gudam, which will help to increase the weight. It's a long-term process. You have to consistent by taking all these medications. Can Shastriya Tailabhyanga be used by any age? Yes, it can be. It is mentioned that from day one till the end of your life, you have to do oil massages. So that's why Tailabhyanga is a very must for every person. Can it be used as a moisturizing? Can it be used as a moisturizing? Sun protecting lotion based during summer also. Basically, moisturizing and moisturization and all these things are different, but oil application is a totally different thing. So we will suggest actually oil application is important. Sun protection can be done with the lotion, but still oil massages are important. What time is appropriate for person to apply it all over the body and face? If you're asking about oil, I will suggest 1 hour before your bath, you should apply oil. And if you are using some, like if you are expecting in terms of protective lotions, then whenever you are going out, then you should apply. How to calm Pitta Dosha woman's anger? See, Pitta and anger is a very good combination. It's a permanent combination, you can see. But you have to reduce your Pitta by anti-Pitta food, which I have already explained. My sister is facing irregular periods issue. Can remedy for that? For irregular periods, we have to. She has to do ultrasound. What is the cause? We have to see if it is PCOD. If it is some blood tests are also necessary. If she is having thyroid, we have to rule out what is the cause. Then only this periods issue can be managed. My daughter is 12 years and her periods go on for 11 to 12 days. If it is an initial phase or if it is a menarche, then certain first few months the periods are irregular. Sometimes heavy bleeding, sometimes scanty bleeding is found, but it should not be for a longer period. If it is still she is getting longer period, you have to check her thyroids, if she is suffering from any thyroid related problem. And then anti-pitta diet, like give her pomegranate juice, give her lots of raisins. That will help to reduce the excess pitta in her body and definitely will help in her periods also. What about skin conditions like urticaria? Urticaria is a allergic condition which you get like rashes on the skin. If you are having any specific allergy, then you have to find out what allergy you are having. If it is not, then it could be because of the excess pitta. So in such a condition, we are doing Vaman or a Virechan Panchakarma treatment. Along with that, Haridra Khandam is one of the famous medicine for the urticaria. So half spoon, 3 to 4 times a day can be taken. How one can prepare Shastriya Tailabhyanga by oneself? What are the ingredients? So Shastriya Tailabhyanga means the Abhyangam which is mentioned in the scriptures, Shastras. So that means you don't have to prepare your oil. It's a any medicated oil, like a Dhanvantaram oil can be used. All the are Shastriya Tailabhyanga only. So the main ingredient is a bala. My father is 82 and his legs are swollen. You have to check out what is the condition, if leg swelling is there, if there is any cardiac involvement, if there is any nephropathic renal involvement is there, we have to rule out with the blood test. Then only we'll come to know what is the reason for the swelling of the legs. My mother is 78 and has a chronic pain in the right arm. She doesn't like to visit doctor. This question I think I have answered already. Then few more questions we will see. Is pomegranate good in cold? See, pomegranate is a anti-pitta food. Can be given in the cold, but you can add little black pepper powder or cumin seed powder into it, and then can be given in a cold conditions also. Solution for white discharge is 6 years. See, white discharge again. If any hormonal imbalance is there, you have to check out. White discharge needs to be treated properly by a proper Ayurveda doctor. So you have to find out good doctor and get treated, because long term white discharge is not good. It may give bigger infections also. And important food remedy which you can do is give anti-pitta food. The food which is not pungent, which is not irritating, which is not hot, which is not spicy. So all those things like a more sweet taste, more bitter taste, and more astringent taste. All three taste. For example, raisins, pomegranate, cow ghee, cow milk can be given in excess. She is suffering from hypo. Can she take ashwagandha? Yes, if someone is suffering from hypothyroidism, ashwagandha can be given, which will help her. Any recommendations for my 75 years old mother who gets angry and confused, doesn't realize she is getting angry and is always more in the morning? See, basically, if she's a pitta dominant person, then she may, pitta dominant person may get angry because when they are hungry. So first thing is you have to give her some breakfast if she's a pitta dominant lady. Another thing is you can give her either Manasa Mitra Vatakam or you can give her Shatavari or Ashwagandha, which will help her. Specifically, I'll recommend Ashwagandha, which will help her more calm down. What do you suggest for water retention in menopause? Water retention is very common, but it is only in that time period when your hormones, when you go through menopause, automatically this water retention comes down. But during that time period, you can give her Punarnava water. Punarnava is a herb which you get in a powder form or in a tablet form, which helps in a water retention. Menopause period is going now, some allergy appearing when eating protein rich food which has tamarind and lemon. This definitely, if you are a pitta dominant person, you are going to face these problems. Take more triphala, take cumin seed or coriander seed water, and take anti-pitta diet. This will help. Take shatavari along with the milk. That will also help. My father is 79 and how to increase the metabolism? Give him cumin seed water and include more ginger in his diet. So, can you suggest which oil is best for pouring in navel area as per season wise and prakriti wise, best time to do the same? Specifically, in the evening timing, is the evening timing 6 to 7 is the best time. But if you are getting any abdominal issues or during periods when you get cramps in abdomen, that time, anytime, whenever the pain is severe, that time also this oil can be used. For this, actually, specifically, we suggest castor oil. So castor oil can be applied can be put in the navel area. I'm here, I'm working in Govardhan Ayurveda. If you have any, if you want to contact me, my phone number is 9763338092, or you can contact me at Rajeshri K. Deshmukh @gmail.com. Can menopause occur at the age of a 36 year old? So as my bleeding has increased suddenly and we went to have a baby, we want to have a baby, what do you suggest? Generally menopause, very rarely seen early menopause, but mostly it occurs after 40 only. If you are 36, then you have to see why, what is the reason for the bleeding. So first you have to do ultrasound, go for a sonography test and find out what is the reason and then rule out the reason. After that, you can have some rejuvenation treatment or panchakarma treatment and then rejuvenation and then go for the conception. Stomach has to be empty or with full for oil pouring. Basically 6 to 7, that time stomach is always empty because we take our dinner after that only. So it is good on the empty stomach, but in case of emergency, even in the, on the full stomach also, you can do mild massage till the oil gets absorbed, and that massage should be in a clockwise direction. Yes, Simi, I can post my details in the WhatsApp group. I will post my number also in the WhatsApp group, so you may not miss it. Okay. So I think we will stop here. We are already crossed our time limit. So thank you for all of you for your patient listening. And I think I, with the knowledge which I have gone, I have gained through the Ayurveda, it will help you, specifically in old age people, it will help to some extent and they will get relief from their problems. And I'll wish all of you a happy Women's Day. We all women, we have to become strong with the help of Ayurveda so that we can serve our families and indirectly we can serve the societies also. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Is it fine to end the session now?
Yes, Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.